Hello all, in this video we are going to see a problem statement wherein we have to load three different source files into a single target file. However, structure of our target file is slightly different. Now if you compare record set in first.txt, which is our source file, one of the source file, so it has header record, and if you check corresponding record set in the target file, it also has header record along with the date. So that is, first record is exactly the same. After that, this from second record onwards, you have three body records. Now if you compare these body records over here, these are exactly the same. Only the difference is here body row is getting replaced with body detail row. After that, after the third column, you have extra fourth column in a target, which is nothing but the date, which is available in the header record. Along with that, there is one extra record in the header target file, which is body header. Now what body header record indicates is it just tells us how many body records you have between header and footer in a particular file. So in this case, there are three records between header and footer. That's the reason it indicates number three. After that, the third column, you have a date, which is nothing but the second column in a header record. And the last column is summation of header records, second column, that is 600 in this case. Now this entire transformation logic, that is addition of this fourth column, creation of this extra record, and transforming or replacing this body row to body detail row and footer with end, will do using the Java transformation, except this aggregation part, that is number, that is count of header records and summation of second column, will be doing using the aggregator transformation. So let's start creating a mapping first. Let's import the source. Okay, so import from file, so text file, take any text file, problem source, it's delimited using tab. We'll keep each field as text 10. Let's create the target, problem target, add dummy column, field 1, precision as 100. Create the mapping. At target. Now let's first create the count and sum. And for that we will be using aggregator transformation. Before importing the ports to aggregator transformation, we first have to identify. Now if you see, we need to count only the body records. That means we will have to, or we should ignore first and last, that is header and footer records. So to ignore those records, we'll add filter transformation. Header. Footer. So field 1 will have equals header, then false, else again if field 1 equals, then false, else true. Now let's create two additional ports, o underscore count, data type would be integer, o underscore sum, again data type would be integer. Count of field 1, and for summation we'll have to sum second column. So sum of fill2. Now if you validate it, it will fail because fill2 is a string value, or data type of fill2 is a string. So let's convert that to integer first. Okay, now here we'll be doing this aggregation for each particular file. So we have to, in order to select group by port, we need file name. Let's go back to the source, add file name port, and drag that port till aggregator. Select that group by. So we got sum and count values. Now we need actual values as well. So let's create another branch. Actual value, and bring these actual values from second branch. And only way to join these two different sources is using joiner. So count, sum, and actual values. Since sources of our joiner coming from only one source qualifier, we have to select sorted input. Joining condition between these two sources is file name. Okay, now let's add our Java logic in order to transform the values and to create additional rows, additional row after header. So Java transform, since we are creating an additional row, it would be active transformation. We don't need file name in this case. All these would be input ports. Let's create an output, go underscore output, and let's consider it as 100. If field 1 starts with header, so if you check the out file, if field 1 starts with header, then output will be header and a date. So let's save the date in a global variable, because that will be needed at number of places. So date is a column 2, field 2 in header record, and the first record in out file would be field 1 plus date. Compile it and also call generate row function in order to create the actual row. So by this way we have created first row in out file. The second row is body header. So let's add, so again out file would be body header, which is a constant value. After that you have count, after count you have date, and after date you have sum. Let's compile the code add call generator function. So we have done with the second record as well. Now is the third record, that is actual body records. So if field 1 starts with body row, that indicates it's a body records. Field 1 starts with in that case replace this body row with body detail row. So again output would be field 1 replace body row with body detail row. Oops. After that you have field 2, field 3, and last fourth column, extra column would be date. So field 2, field 3, and date. Compile and call generator function. So we have done with third record body records as well. So now the last, if there is a footer, field 1 is footer, replace that with end. So else if field 1 starts with footer, then just add end. And call generator function. Okay, so we have added our Java logic. Let's complete our mapping, create the corresponding workflow. Since there are three different files, we will be using indirect method. And file list is this file list file, and we'll keep out file at same folder where we are, where our source files are. So problem target out file dot, let's run the workflow and see if we are getting the desired output or not. So it read 14 records and created 17 records at out file, since we have to create one additional record for each particular source file. Problem target out file. Okay, now if you see the difference between actual out file or required out file and created out file is, the required out file is separated by tab, whereas our file is not separated by anything. So in order to separate each particular record with a tab, we have to add ASCII value. So in a Java, in order to separate the out file or output with a tab separation, we'll replace that with ASCII 9. So if you see, this ASCII value in Java is nothing but the tab. It's common for all the languages, not particularly for Java. So let's add this additional code. Oops. Over here. Here. I think we are good. Let's replace this code again, compile it, refresh the workflow, execute the workflow. 14, 17. Now let's check the target. Okay, now our out file is a tab separated, which is exactly same as our expected out file. Thank you for watching this video.